fight scheduled for 8 rounds between David Horvath of Winnipeg and Hercules Cavelos. And Cavelos, Stephen, definitely the guy to watch for here.
Yeah, Herc Cavelos is the story here. A terrific amateur, a member of Canada's Olympic team in Atlanta, and a real slick boxer. He's an interesting combination of things. A slick boxer, very good hand speed, good power, and one of these guys who I think is going to be a better pro than he was an amateur.
That's interesting because a lot of them had to make that transition from amateur to pro. Some quite successfully, some far better in the pro ranks than they are as amateurs. Could this be one of those guys?
I think so, because the professional game is all about putting on a show. And Herc Cavelos is a guy who's going to be very entertaining. As an amateur, he was like a lot of guys. He was the pick and poke with the jab, trying to score points with the judges. But as a pro, he's a guy, he's flashy enough, and he's got enough power that I think people are going to pay to see him.
That's the thing you'll notice, maybe even more so than the power, the speed compared to the lumbering heavyweights that we just saw. The kind of speed that he has, could that make him a world-class fighter very soon?
You know, it's hard to say because it depends on how he's managed, it depends on how he's moved, but he certainly appears to have the total package to become a top-ranked pro.
Hercules Cavelos, Montreal, definitely the favorite in this bout as they enter the ring now as we head back to the Molson Center. First, a look at David Horvath of Winnipeg and a record of 3-2 with a couple of knockouts. We really don't know much about Horvath except that from what we've seen about Cavelos, he could be in for quite a bout tonight.
Well, I mean, you've got to figure he's in tough here. Cavelos is the attraction. He's the guy that they're trying to build, and Horvath is here to be a stepping stone. I want to be yours, but baby, yours and yours alone. I'm here to tell you, honey.
Horvath looking pretty relaxed as he heads in. Another sight of the Molson Center and a good spectacle for boxing. A crowd over 11,000 at the Molson Center this evening. Sure that Herc Cavelos of Montreal will get a warm greeting as he heads out. Horvath in the ring already, waiting for his opponent. You get the idea now as the crowd picks up in the music that Herc Cavelos is on his way.
Screaming. Herc Cavelos has his own fans that come just to see him. He has 300 or 400 people in the crowd who are just there for Herc Cavelos.
A lot of good fighters from Quebec and maybe the most passionate boxing fans right now. I know in Edmonton there are many, but could be in Quebec and especially Montreal.
I think Edmonton's the only place in Canada that could give Montreal a run for its money, but I think right now, especially with this Interbox promotion, Montreal looks like the fight capital of Canada.
Hercules Cavelos with the hood on and a serious demeanor. Making his way through, age 22, and a 5-0 record, 4 by knockout. Stephen mentioned he's got power, and the thing you will notice about him as well, he's got cat-like quickness.
Again, just 22 years of age, so he's probably turned pro at the right stage in his life to develop as a professional. It's his trainer, Russ Amber, leading him out there, who trains world champion Otis Grant.
Middleweight class, Herc Cavelos looking to improve to 6-0, taking on Winnipeg's David Horvath. And we'll be back right after this break with round one, Horvath and Cavelos. In Montreal, in the next fight on the card, a scheduled 8-round bout, junior middleweights, Hercules Cavelos of Montreal, the crowd favorite at 5-0 with 4 knockouts. He'll be the favorite against David Horvath of Winnipeg, 3-2 with 2 knockouts.
Now, Herc Cavelos is one of these, is a fighter a lot of people are excited about, was a very good amateur, member of the national team, but he's got one of those styles that he might be a better pro than an amateur in.
Do I have any questions? Remember to obey my commands at all times. Let's touch gloves. Good luck to both of you.
And the big stare by Hercules there. David Horvath, Stephen, coming in at over 162 pounds while Cavelos at 154.
Yeah, big weight disparity, and it was a bit of an issue. Came in over the contracted weight, but they let this one go.
Cavelos in the black trunks, Horvath in the white. And round one underway.
Cavelos, a very slick boxer, had a reputation as a very stylish fighter as an amateur, but he's shown a lot more power than people expected as a pro.
And a lot of speed, dancing, trying to snap his left, not landing anything yet. Horvat staying back. Five pro fights, as mentioned, 3-2, but in tough here against the favorite. Montreal's own Covello.
Covello's moving very well and throwing a nice jab, nice quick jab.
Dancing around. Neither fighter yet to land early on in this scheduled eight rounder. And Covello's using his speed and getting back quickly as well.
Good body shot there, too. Finished with a left hook to the body. It's a great thing to see from a young fighter.
Horvat coming across with a right. And Covello's slipping a little bit in the center of the ring.
Horvat just had a lot of trouble with Covello's speed here and the way Covello's puts punches together in combination.
Approaching the midway point of round one. And in comes Covello's. Has Horvath up against the ropes. Lands a right.
Look at the way he comes in behind that jab. One, two, three jabs and then throwing combinations off him.
Having seen the heavyweight fight moments earlier, this is a bit of a shock, Stephen, the speed of these lighter fighters.
Well, Covello's has got exceptional speed for some of the for a junior middleweight. They just landed another good body shot that hurt Horvath a bit.
Coming in with a left, gets a nice right uppercut on David Horvath.
And another great, look at that, terrific.
And Horvath is down after that body shot with the left of Covello's. And he's waits and is up on the seven count to resume fighting with 27 seconds to go in the round.
Now let's see if Covello's can finish here. He's got him hurt.
Happy combination by Covello's. He's all over Horvath.
Great hand speed, great combinations. And another body shot. Down from another body shot.
Down again. And this might be it. He may not last the round. The clock can't save him, and it's over. First round knockout, Hercules Covello's. And the Montreal faithful love it.
His trainer, Russ Amber, there, who also trains Otis Grant, world champion, world middleweight champion. Dwight Fraser in his corner. You know, a lot of people ask, who's the next great Canadian fighter? Who's coming up? There's a guy, Hurt Covello's, who has everything, who has all the tools, he's got speed, he's a terrific boxer, and he can punch a little bit.
Great combination, Stephen, setting this up.
That's the thing, you know, throwing multiple punches, coming in off the jab, and this and the body punching. Terrific body punching. There's the left hook to the liver that ends the fight.
Second time and the last time Horvath goes down, and all in round one, as Hercules Covello's improves his record to 6-0 with 5 knockouts. And another look at what ended this bout in a hurry.
The 10-12 punches there before the final punch. And a left hook to the body.
So Hercules Covello's wins this junior middleweight bout over David Horvath.
Covello's improves to 6-0 in this junior middleweight bout. He defeated David Horvath with a first-round knockout, meaning he has 5 knockouts in his early career. Now some words post-match from Hercules Covello's.
So we're now with Hercules Covello's, who won a great fight, a very quick fight for you tonight. Was that what you expected, what you were aiming for?
Actually, no, it wasn't. We expected him to come out a lot more aggressive. He was heavy, and he came out, we expected him to come out a lot stronger than that, but we knew he had the weight on us. We didn't want to take chances with the power. We wanted to test him, feel him off. And he gave it to me. I mean, I took the opportunity. I'm that kind of fighter. As soon as I get the chance, I go. As soon as he gave it to me, I took it.
22 years of age and showing a lot of promise, a young boxer in this country, Hurt Covello's. I know you know his trainer, Russ Amber, quite well. First of all, your reaction to the fight tonight?
Well, he certainly lived up to his billing. All, you know, the hand speed we were talking about before, the power, he really looked terrific in that fight. And I think Russ Amber's got to be thrilled with that performance.
Now, how quickly do you bring a guy along like this? Because he does show a lot of potential.
Well, you know, it's tempting to rush him because, again, he's got so much going for him. But Russ Amber, anybody who knows him and the way he moved Otis Grant, he's incredibly careful with his own fighter. So he will be doing everything he can to build him slowly, to give Covello some experience. After all, he's only 22. Give him some experience in the pro game and then move him slowly and gradually to a title shot.
That was not a title match, but the next fight is a cruiserweight meeting between a journeyman, Art Jimmerson, and Canadian Dale Brown of Calgary for the North American Boxing Federation cruiserweight title. Dale Brown is the champion, of course, the Canadian champ as well. And that, our next meeting coming up from the Molson Centre in Montreal. Dale Brown sporting an impressive record of 14-0-1. This guy is world class.
Well, Dale Brown was another guy who was a great amateur. He fought, I think he won two medals in the World Amateur Championships for Canada. He is the protege as a pro of Donnie Lalonde, the former light heavyweight champion, and Lalonde has been his manager. Actually, Lalonde, who isn't officially retired yet, was fighting on cards with Dale Brown for a while there. Lalonde has now joined Interbox as a manager promoter. Dale Brown has moved to Interbox, and in the cruiserweight division, where traditionally there isn't a tremendous amount of talent, he can move very quickly to a world title shot.
Right now he is ranked 10th by the